In this video, you're going to see how I cloned ChatGPT starting in the new build feature in AI Studio in Gemini. I'm going to show you how to use this tool. It's really powerful. Putting it into Cursor and continuing to build features. But before we jump into how I did it, let me show you what I built. And I did this in literally 24 hours. Fully hosted on Vercel, so it's live on the internet. The design, I think, turned out really nice. And let me show you what features we built and how it works. And you can see it's really pretty close to most of the chat apps that you may see out there. It's running with Gemini in the backend. So I'm using the Gemini 2.5 Flash model for most of the things, but I also have some helper models using to do a few other things, which I'll show you in a second. So let's say I want to ask a question. So I'm going to say latest Tesla news. And you can see I'm not even turning on web search. Just by default, what we have is a model that's checking the input and it's going to automatically search the web. So this is very similar to what you might see with ChatGPT or other models. You can see the sources. It's using the Exa API to actually do a web search and get information. And then we have all these inline links as well to link to the sources. And then we can see the sources below. So that shows a lot of the features in one. Also, we have a little model to name the chat based on the first message. And then you can respond and you can say, tell me more about, let's say, the future of robotics. And it's going to search the web again because it doesn't know that on its own. But I'm going to show you in a second that not every search is going to use the web automatically. But this I was pretty proud of that it worked. And in a second, I'm going to show you the whole workflow that I did to build this. And again, I built this in literally 24 hours. So here we go. We have more information about that. So cool that it did that. Now let's go ahead and do a new chat. So I have a few other things here. You can also select like recipe help, and that's just going to modify the system prompt a little bit if you want to do that, or we can do it just from the main chat. So we're going to send that and you're going to see it's not going to do web search for this because for this query, it doesn't need to search the internet. So all of that is just built in. We have streaming built in as well. So yeah, those basic features. So you can see where it did search the web and where it didn't. Now, one other thing I want to show you is we added the ability to upload images because Gemini is a multimodal model, meaning it can have text or image. So you can do it from anywhere. But let's just say, just for fun, let's take a screenshot of this. I'll paste it in and then the image just gets pasted. And let's say I built this landing page. Any ideas for different hero text? So we can go ahead and send this. Again, it is not searching the web because it doesn't need to for this response. And then we're going to get the response in a second. So here we go. We know it read it because it says, okay, your current text, ask anything, get instant answers is clear. But here are some other options. Cool that it was able to do this. Again, this is all running with Gemini in the background. And I used the Gemini build feature in the AI Studio to get started. So this is all built out. Let me show you the workflow of how I actually did it. Also, if you want to learn more about how to do this, click the link in the description to go to our SaaS building course with AI, where I'll teach you how to go from idea to fully functioning web app, just like you saw in the example. So here we are in the build feature of the AI Studio. Just go to ai.dev. It's totally free to use this in Google. You don't even need to have an account. But what I did was I basically started by saying, let's build a chat app similar to ChatGPT, but I want to use the Gemini 2.5 Flash model for responses. So you could do something just like that. Let's just go ahead and do that just to see what it comes up with. And then this is almost like a lovable clone or a bolt clone. It is going to help you build websites, build apps. But what's really cool about this is because it's integrated in AI Studio with Gemini, you can build AI powered apps. So apps that have this AI functionality, like the chat app I just showed you, but it's going to do all of that on its own. You don't have to worry about setting up an API key, setting up another service. It's just going to do it all here. It's only when you want to take it off this platform and start building it on your own that all you have to do is just get an API key. And then it's just put it into the app because it's going to have it ready for you. And then you are all set at that point. So here it's building it out. This is very similar to what you might see on something like Lovable. Here it is writing all the code, literally just as simple as that. We have a chat and let's just message. I'll say, hi, how are you? So I can send it and cool. We got the response and basically we have a simple app, but let's say we want to build even more on top of this before we want to get off of this platform. So why don't we say, can you please build more features, a home screen where users home screen, let's say ChatGPT has, see what it can do, a sidebar with chat history. And it's going to build chat history into the local browser for now, which is something that once you get it off, this is part of the workflow. Once you get off of this platform by syncing to GitHub, which I'm going to show you in a second, and then start using it in Cursor or somewhere else, you then would just ask Cursor to then hook it up with a database. In my case, I used Supabase, and then it'll just convert everything for you. So just something to keep in mind here. But it's nice to do as much as you can here with Gemini, because first, it's free, and it does a really good job at integrating the Gemini AI capabilities. So it went and created a plan. We can see what it's doing, three steps, UI layout overhaul, sidebar and home screen. And then it's going to proceed with the code modifications to bring it to life. All right, so we have our next version of the app here. So cool. It's just really fun to be able to do this. And you could just, any idea that you had, you would be able to build it out here in the AI Studio for free. It has these kind of ChatGPT-like prompts. We can say a new chat, say, hi there, can you tell me a story about basketball? And let's see, just to make sure it works. And then we have our chat history here. Cool. It's working. It's streaming in as well, which is cool that it has the streaming added. And then if we go back to chat, let's just say plan a trip. And then now we have our chat history and we can click between it, which is nice to see. And we could add even more features if we want. We could say, let the user select the model. We could add image generation. You could really build like your own personal chat right in here. And then you would never even have to leave it if you want. You could just come in here. You could deploy the app here. But what I'm going to talk about next is the next workflow. So we could spend a lot of time here in the AI Studio, but let me talk about the workflow of how I went from this to this, because that's basically what happened. It went from that to this with more features, and you just keep building on in Cursor using AI. And I'm actually not sure how far you could get just in AI Studio. You might be able to get really far. I left maybe around this point in terms of my workflow, but you could keep building on in AI Studio, especially because it's free. Okay, so if we click save to GitHub, that's what you're going to need to do. You're going to have to go through some steps to connect your GitHub. But once you connect your GitHub, all of the code is going to get synced from here, from AI Studio into your GitHub. Once code is in your GitHub, you have that code, you own it, you can do anything that you want with it. So you want to go from GitHub to Cursor. And I have other videos on that as well, which if you check out our channel, we have other videos of going from Lovable to Cursor, for example. It's a very similar process where you go to GitHub, get the link that you need. And then if you go to Cursor, here you are in Cursor. All you have to do is click clone repo. You would paste in the URL from GitHub, and then now you're working in Cursor. From there, I connected my Supabase account to Cursor so that I would have a backend database, and then continued building on features from there. So I hope this is a helpful overview. If you like it, let me know. I could go into even more detail of how I built the ChatGPT clone, more detail about the API connections, what are the workflows, how is it deciding when to use web search and not use web search, how is the database set up. So let me know what you think in the comments, and I can definitely go deeper if this is a topic that you're interested in. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this, and we'll see you in the next video.